This forecast is powered by Comfort Now, comprehensive heating and cooling solutions for Atlantic and Gateway counties.
A gorgeous day to spend some time outdoors. I certainly took my advice from earlier on this morning. Our Glen Insurance Cam shows you our weather shot today from Valley Green. That's where I spent my afternoon. It's just north of Philadelphia in Valley Kenwood, and they have trails that go all over the place. And we were able to just chill out for a second and watch this waterfall. Also watch somebody off in the distance who was just kind of laying there like this. Still don't know what they were doing, but our best goes out to them, and we hope they were okay. 59 degrees, our official high temperature at the airport in Egg Harbor Township. Winds right now north-northwest at about 18 miles an hour. That is down from where we were earlier on. I'm going to show you some eye-popping numbers. 48 right now in Philadelphia, 50 in Atlantic City, 41 in Scranton, 50 for Washington, and 46 in the Harrisonburg area. Those winds were out of the northwest all day out of a cooler direction, even though we were able to get into the mid and upper 50s earlier on. 49 in Hamilton and Mays Landing, 48 for Woodland Township, 50 for Millville and the Fortescue area, even down along our Cape May County beaches, coming in the upper 40s to around 50. Lower Alloways Township, you take the cake. You had the highest wind gust today at 46 miles an hour. Fortescue, Pennsauken, lower 40s. If you didn't make the leaderboard, trust me, it was still windy, gust to over 35 miles an hour for much of the area. Right now, they're starting to wind down a little bit, but it's still going to be on the breezy side tonight. All right, let's talk about this mega storm offshore that is continuing to intensify, and it's not going to back up to our shore, but we are going to see a residual impact. The first thing you're going to notice, clouds are going to be on the increase tonight. They'll thicken up, and we have this little surface trough extending from the center of the storm. This is going to move down from northeast to southwest, and that's going to bring a not so nice Friday. It's not going to be a washout, but we will have some wet weather on our radar map, and it's just going to be yucky with clouds locked in overhead. And it looks like the clouds will actually continue into a good portion of your Saturday, and then eventually we'll clear out. I think Sunday is your pick day of the weekend. 42 clouds move in, and like I said, they'll thicken up overnight. Temperatures tomorrow morning in the low to mid 40s, northwest winds at about 10 to 15 miles an hour. So it's not as extremely windy as today was, but still breezy. Greenland across the board on your travel for the Parkway, the Expressway, and Route 55. For your Friday, let's go cloudy skies, 56 degrees, a few showers, especially before noon. We talked about it's not going to be a direct impact, but the residual impact is going to mean beach erosion and tidal flooding. And in fact, some of our latest guidance coming in kind of upping the numbers. We're specifically looking at the early morning high tide on Saturday coming up at 4:47 in Atlantic City, 5:38 in Ocean City. So you get it before 6 o'clock for most of the area. So if you're a late riser and you're up at 9 or 10 o'clock, you're probably not going to notice it. But before you go to bed, if you're living in an area that's impacted by flooding in these types of situations, just move your car to higher ground, because you might not even know that your car was sitting in water unless you go out and, you know, check on it in the middle of the night. Moderate tidal flooding is possible. I think most of us stay under it, but it's always the best practice to prepare for more and hope for less. Fortescue getting in on some minor tidal flooding. But the general rule, I think the farther south you go into Cape May County, the better the chance of moderate flooding becomes. Saturday will start off cloudy. I think some afternoon clearing could initiate. Double nickels, no wet weather, so we're not looking at any rain. That's good news. 7-day forecast Sunday, nice. How about, I did it again. That should actually read 62 degrees. It's not going to be 50 on Sunday. Got to go in the computer and change that. Then we are going to be in the 60s for much of next week. Mid and upper 60s, actually. So get used to spring temperatures. Or I guess we could say welcome spring temperatures. Have yourselves a great night.